Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create your first Angular project. Okay, so on my screen, I have Visual Studio Code open. I also have the terminal open at the bottom here. If you don't know how to open the terminal inside of Visual Studio Code, you can just come up to the menu here at the top and select Terminal. And then you'll have New Terminal set right there. However, I don't need to do this as I already have the terminal open. Now, if you haven't already done so, quickly make sure that in the terminal, you are in a directory where you want to create your first project. I'm happy where I am, so I don't need to do anything here either. Now, I am assuming that if you are watching this video, you have already installed the Angular CLI for version 9. If you haven't, you'll need to do that first and then come back to this video. But if you have, well, let's build our first Angular project, shall we? So to do this, we will use our very first Angular CLI command, and that is the new command. The new command allows us to create new Angular projects with some basic building blocks. It will also add a development server, so it's easy for us to run it locally on our machine. We can run the new command and create a new project by typing the following on the command line. ng, with ng being the name of the executable for the Angular CLI, followed by a space, then the keyword new, which indicates that we want to run the new command. Then lastly, we set a name for this new project. So I'm just going to call it hello-angular. Now, if we press return or enter if you're on Windows, you'll be prompted with a couple of questions. The first one asks if you want to add routing to your Angular application. For now, I'm just going to set this to no by typing in an N and then pressing enter. Let's keep it simple for now. We'll cover routing a little bit later. You will then be prompted with what stylesheet format you want to use in your application. Once again, I'm going to keep it simple and choose the first option and select CSS. We might look at the other options that are there a little bit later. So I'll just press return, and now the CLI will begin downloading and provisioning all the files needed to run your Angular project. Now this can take up to a couple of minutes, but with the magic of video editing, I'll just skip ahead. So here we are, a few minutes later, and hopefully you're seeing a message similar to mine, saying that the packages have been installed correctly, and you also can see a whole bunch of green creates. Once we get to this point, we are ready to open the project in Visual Studio Code. So now I'm going to come up to the file menu at the top here and choose open. Now fortunately for me, the finder remembered I was in my Angular 9 folder last time. But at this point, you just need to navigate to your new hello-angular folder, click on it, and then select to open. Now, it might take a few seconds, but eventually you'll see a whole bunch of files that look like this. Now, I won't explain what they all do right now. We'll cover that a little bit later. Cool, so we've created our first project. The good thing is we can also run it and see what it looks like. To run our project, we need to quickly open up the terminal once again. Once we have our terminal open, we will now run our second Angular CLI command, and that is the serve command. And that's pretty straightforward. We once again just type ng, then a space, and then the word serve, then press enter. What this will do is it will build your source code and then boot up your development server and start your application. This can take about a minute or so. So once again, with the magic of editing, we'll skip ahead. And now, as you can see, it says that the live development server is running and is listening on port 4200 on localhost. It should also say that the code compiled successfully. Now, at this time, it's quite likely that your application was also opened inside the browser and shown to you. If it wasn't, well, you can come over to the address bar and just type localhost colon and then 4200. And there it is. So congratulations, you now have your first Angular 9 application built and running in the browser. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe to my channel, and hit that notification bell. And I'll see you all next time.